Students, today we are going to learn about the third type of ratios called activity ratio or turnover ratio or efficiency ratio. Look at the board. Third type of ratio, it's called a turnover ratio or activity ratio or efficient ratio. It must be expressed in form of time. What do you mean by turnover ratio? Turnover ratio shows how assets and other items have been used to generate revenue from operation. There are four type of turnover ratio. First ratio we are going to learn is inventory turnover ratio. Ratio number one, inventory turnover ratio. Inventory turnover ratio. Today we are going to learn only formulas. Inventory turnover ratio. Formula for this, cost of revenue from operation divided by average stock. Cost of revenue from operation divided by average stock. Average stock means average inventory. Now we learn the formula of cost of revenue from operation. Cost of revenue from operation. For this formula is formula number one, opening inventory plus net purchase plus direct expenses minus closing inventory, or we can use net purchase plus or minus change in the value of inventories. Here, if opening stock exceeds closing stock, we have to add. If opening stock is less than the closing stock, we have to deduct. So we should be careful about here. Net purchase plus or minus change in the value of inventory plus direct expenses. Direct expenses, we know the items which are debited to the trading account. Or one more formula we have, that is revenue from operation minus gross profit. Next we have to learn average inventories. If there are two inventories, namely opening inventory and closing inventory, opening inventory plus closing inventories are given. That time we have to use opening inventories plus closing inventories divided by 2. If only one inventory that we should assume as closing inventory, that we can write directly. Students, if two inventories are given, we have to use this formula, opening inventory plus closing inventory divided by 2. If one inventory is given that we should assume as closing inventory, that we can use directly. Okay, then we have to learn inventory conversion period. Then we have to learn about inventory conversion period. Then we have to learn inventory conversion period. If it is in days, the formula is days in a year divided by inventory turnover ratio. Inventory turnover ratio. If they ask in months, the formula is months in a year divided by inventory turnover ratio. Once again, the first ratio is inventory turnover ratio. Formula is cost of revenue from operation divided by average stock or average inventory. Cost of revenue from operation formula is opening inventory plus net purchase plus direct expenses minus closing inventory. Second formula, net purchase plus or minus change in the value of inventory of finished goods. Inventory of finished goods. Here, for example, opening stock 60,000, closing stock 40,000. So the difference 20,000 we have to add because the opening stock exceeds the closing stock, so the difference should be added with the net purchase. Then case number 2, opening stock 30,000, closing stock 40,000. Here we have to deduct because closing stock exceeds the opening stock. Next, third formula, revenue from operation minus gross profit. Then we have to find average inventory. What is the formula? If two inventories are given, opening inventory plus closing inventory divided by 2. If one inventory is given, that we can use directly as average inventory. Okay. Then we have to find one more item called inventory conversion period. If they ask in days, the formula is days in a year divided by inventory turnover ratio. If they ask in month, the formula is months in a year divided by inventory turnover ratio. The second ratio we are going to learn about, accounts receivable turnover ratio. Accounts receivable turnover ratio. Formula, credit revenue from operation divided by average accounts receivable. Credit revenue from operation divided by average accounts receivable. Always credit revenue from operation will be given. We have to find average accounts receivable. Average accounts receivable. Case number 1. Opening debtor plus closing debtor divided by 2. If two debtors are given, we have to use this formula. Opening debtor plus closing debtor divided by 2. Case number 2. Opening accounts receivable plus closing accounts receivable divided by 2. If they give opening accounts receivable and closing accounts receivable, we have to use this formula. 3. Opening debtor plus closing debtor divided by 2 plus opening bills receivable plus closing bills receivable divided by 2. Sometime two debtor, two bills receivable are given. That time we have to take average of debtor and average of bills receivable. Then we have to add together, recorded as average accounts receivable. Then case number 4. Sometime one debtor, one BR given. Assume that both as closing balance. We have to add and record as average accounts receivable. Case number 5. Only one debtor is given. Consider that one as closing debtor. Directly we can record as average accounts receivable. Once again, accounts receivable turnover ratio, credit revenue from operation divided by average accounts receivable. Credit revenue from operation always given. We have to find average accounts receivable. For that, we have to use the formula according to the available information. If two debtor are given, opening debtor plus closing debtor divided by 2. If two accounts receivable are given, opening accounts receivable plus closing accounts receivable divided by 2. Sometime two debtor, two BR given. So that time we have to use opening debtor plus closing debtor divided by 2 plus opening bills receivable plus closing bills receivable divided by 2. Fourth formula, sometime one debtor, one BR is given. Consider both one as closing balance. Add together, record as average accounts receivable. Sometime only one debtor is given, that we should assume as closing debtor. We can record as average accounts receivable. Then sometime they may ask debt collection period. If they ask in days, formula, days in a year divided by accounts receivable turnover ratio. We'll get debt collection period in days. If they ask in months, the formula is months in a year divided by accounts receivable turnover ratio. Students in turnover ratio, there are four items of which we completed two ratios formula. We'll see third and fourth ratio formula. Students, now we learn the formula for third ratio called accounts payable turnover ratio. Yes, formula for this: net credit purchases divided by average accounts payable. Net credit purchase always given. We have to find average accounts payable. Case number one, opening creditor plus closing creditor divided by 2. If opening creditor and closing creditor are given, we have to use this formula: opening creditor plus closing creditor divided by 2. Or case number 2, opening accounts payable plus closing accounts payable divided by 2. If opening accounts payable and closing accounts payable are given, we have to use this formula. Then third one, opening creditor plus closing creditor divided by 2 plus opening bills payable plus closing bills payable divided by 2. When two creditor and two bills payable, opening creditor and closing creditor are given, we have to use opening creditor plus closing creditor divided by 2 plus opening bills payable plus closing bills payable divided by 2. Then sometime creditor and bills payable are given. Assume these two closing balances add together, write it as average accounts payable. Then last case, only creditor is given. Consider that one as closing creditor, record as average accounts payable. Next, we have to find one more thing called debt payment period. Debt payment period. If they ask in days, the formula is days in a year divided by average accounts payable turnover ratio. If they ask in days, if they ask in months, the formula is months in a year divided by average accounts payable turnover ratio. If they ask in days, formula is days in a year divided by average accounts payable turnover ratio. If they ask in months, formula is months in a year divided by average accounts payable turnover ratio. The last ratio is fixed assets turnover ratio. Formula: revenue from operation divided by average fixed assets. Average fixed asset we can calculate with the help of these two formula. Formula number one, opening fixed asset, that means opening balance of fixed assets plus closing balance of fixed assets divided by 2. If two fixed assets are given, opening and closing, we have to use this formula. Case number 2, only fixed assets are given. In that case, consider this one as closing fixed asset and average fixed asset, record directly as average fixed asset. Student, we completed formula for inventory turnover ratio. In next class, we'll solve problems in relation to the turnover ratio. Till then, bye and thank you.